हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू एकताज साइंस एजुकेशन क्लास. राइट वे राइट लर्निंग इज अवर मोटो. वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न टुडे क्लास 5 साइंस लेसन नंबर 14 द मून. मून इज द नेचुरल सैटेलाइट ऑफ द अर्थ. नाउ लेट्स लर्न अबाउट मोर अबाउट द मून. हाउ वंडरफुल इज इट टू वॉच द स्काई आफ्टर सनसेट. वन वुड फर्स्ट नोटिस वन और टू ब्राइट डॉट्स शाइनिंग इन द स्काई. सून यू वुड सी द नंबर इंक्रीजिंग. Along with this bright object, you may also see the moon on most of the days. Why it is so? It may, however, appear at the different times, in the different shapes, and at the different positions. You can see the full moon only once in about a month's time. It is full moon night, or we can say Purnima. A fortnight later, you cannot see it at all. It is a night, or it's a new moonlight. That's Amavasya. On this day, you can watch the night sky best provided it is a clear night. Now we know that the sun, the moon, and all those objects shining in the night sky are called celestial bodies or heavenly bodies. We know that sun is a star. Sun is the only source of energy that provides the shape, or we can say the light to whole planets, to whole world. Okay, so sun is a shining star. The moon is a heavenly object that moves around the earth once every 27.3 days. This moon is a companion of earth or a natural satellite of the earth. As earth is doing revolution and rotation, the moon is also doing the revolution, and nearly approximately it takes 27 days for one revolution to complete to the moon. Now the surface of the moon looks grey. It has mountains and plains covered with the rock dust. Now what is exactly the satellite? Now satellite means any heavenly object that revolves round a planet is called a satellite. So the moon is a satellite of the earth. In fact, the moon is the only natural satellite of the earth. The surface of the moon looks grey. It has a mountains, plains covered with the rock dust. Now if we consider the age, or if we find out the age of the moon is about 4,500 million years, same as that of the earth. Now if we have it is a big ball. Now sun or the moon is a big ball, gray rock. It's a big ball of the gray rock. Moon is a big ball of the gray rock, about 1/4 of the size that have that is the earth. Now what is the distance between the moon and the earth? It is near about, it is maximum, or we can say it's approximate. The distance is 384,000 kilometers away from the earth. The moon is 384,400 kilometers away from the earth. If we see the surface of the moon, the surface of the moon looks grey, as you can see here. The surface of the moon looks grey. It has mountains and plains covered with the rock dust. There are many big ball shaped holes. They are said to be the craters of the moon. The craters, how they form? Actually, the craters are ball-shaped holes. You can see ball-shaped holes, which are made by the chunk of the rocks called meteoroid that strike on the moon. And they created such type of holes there, which are said to be the craters. If we see the surface of the moon have mountain, plains, craters on it. That's why we see the shadow from the earth, which are nothing but the shadow of mountains, plains, or the landforms on the moon. There is no life on the moon. Conditions favorable to the support life are only and only probably found on the earth. The earth is neither too hot nor too cold. It has a water, air, which are very essential for the life. The air has life supporting gases like oxygen. Because of these gases or these reasons, the earth is a unique planet in the solar system. If we see the other conditions on the moon, we know the surface of the moon. You can see here in the different images the surface of the moon. The gravitational force on the moon is 1/6 of that on the earth. We know that. What is gravitation? Gravitation is the earth's attractive force which keeps all the things on the earth, on the place. Now that means the gravitational force on the moon is 1/6 of that on the earth. So what will happen? That means your weight on the moon is 6 times less than your weight on the earth. You can see here, the weight of yours here, it is less than, or it is 6 times less than your weight on the earth. Our earth has only one satellite, that is the moon. No? Okay. The moon moves around the earth in about 27 days. It takes exactly the same time to complete one spin. As a result, only one side of the moon is visible to us on the earth. The moon does not have conditions favorable for the life. It has neither water nor air. It has mountains. It has craters. There is almost no atmosphere on the moon. Therefore, there are no plants and animals. Sunlight does not get scattered on the moon because of the absence of the air. There is no air. There is no air on the moon. So the sky looks dark and the stars are visible even during daytime. Sound waves are not able to. There is no sound. Sound waves are not able to travel on the moon since there is no air. So there is no sound on the moon. There is no wind to move the dust on the surface of the moon. So the footprints of the astronauts, will be preserved for many years on the surface of the moon. The moon turns very slowly on its axis. It takes 29.5 days to complete one rotation. So one day on moon is equal to 29.5 days on earth. During the day, the illuminated part of the moon gets very hot. During the night, the dark part of the moon gets very, very cold. Now, the moon rotates one time for every revolution around the earth. So it have the different stages, stage 1, stage 2, stage 3. As you can see, the movement of the moon is there, the stages will be appearing there. We know that moon is a natural satellite. A satellite is a celestial body that moves around the planet in the same way as the planet move around the sun. So the moon is a natural satellite of the earth. Now let's learn about the phases of the moon. The moon does not have its own light. It takes the light from the sun. It reflects the light of the sun. When the moon passes between the earth and the sun, sunlight falls on the part to turn away from the us, and so the moon is not visible to us. This happens on the new moon night. Every night the illuminated part grows in the size till we see the full moon. On the 15th day from the next day, the illuminated part decreases in the size and becomes completely invisible on the 15th day. Here you can see, this is known as the new moon day. From one new moon day to another, it takes around 30 days, and this period is called a lunar month. Lunar means related to the moon. The part of the moon visible to us is called the phase of the moon. Here you can see the new moon, waning crescent, last quarter, then waning gibbons, full moon, waxing gibbous, first quarter, waxing crescent. In this way you can see full moon night and new moon night. These are the different phases of the moon. Now the next part is about how the tides of the ocean get affected with the moon's attraction forces, or the moon's, and what causes the low tide and high tide. Now let us learn about it. The moon and the tides, what is the correlation between them? Tides are the periodic rise and fall of the large bodies of the water caused by the gravity of the moon. एंड द सन. When the water level rises, it is called as a high tide. It is called this is a low tide, and this is a high tide. Now, when it will happen? When the water level rises, it is a high tide, and it is happening because of the gravity or gravitational force between the moon and the earth, between the moon and the sun. And when the water level falls, it is a low tide. It takes about 6 hours for the rising water to reach a high tide. It takes another 6 hours for the falling water to reach to the low tide. The sun, the moon and the earth are in one line during a full moon or a new moon. Their combined gravity causes higher tides than the normal high tides on these days because of the gravitational force between three of them. Three of them means who? Sun, moon and the earth. Next part is artificial satellite. Artificial satellite, we know that moon is the only natural satellite of the earth. Till a few years ago, the moon was the only satellite orbiting around the earth. But now, there are many artificial satellites orbiting the earth. Let's have a look on them. Now, artificial satellite is a human-made object which orbits the earth, which revolves the earth or some other celestial bodies in the space. When an artificial satellite is launched, a rocket takes it up in the space. How? This is how the rocket takes up in the space. Later on, the satellite is put into the orbit. Inside the rocket, there is a satellite which is put on into the orbit. Now, today space shuttles, these are the space shuttles. These are the different parts of the space shuttles. External tank, solid rocket booster and orbiter. These are the parts of the space shuttles. The space shuttles are used to launch satellites nowadays and to recover damaged satellites and return them back to the Earth. A space shuttle has many facilities which help the astronauts to live in the space for many days. You can see the structure of the space shuttle which makes the astronauts to survive in there. Which makes the astronauts to survive inside it for longer time. Now, people who are able to do different work are required on a space shuttle, along with the pilots, engineers who can operate and repair the instrument, scientists who carry our experiment all, and astronomers who study the universe also travel in the space shuttles. They are all astronauts. Now, India's first artificial satellite was Aryabhatta, and it is named after the great scientist, Indian astronomer and mathematician Aryabhatta. India's first artificial satellite was Aryabhatta. It was named after the great Indian astronomer. It was launched by Russia in 1975. It was launched in orbit from Kapustinia, Russia. Now let's have the different uses of the artificial satellite. If we see the different uses, we see the network of the satellites launch in the Earth's orbiter. You know, an artificial satellite is one of the most useful invention for mankind. Different kinds of artificial satellites are designed for different purposes, like communication satellite. These satellites send telephone, television and other electronic signals to and from different places on the earth. Then next is a navigation satellite. These satellites send messages from one country to another, from the land to an aircraft to a ship. They determine the exact locations of the people even in the remote places at any given instant of the time. Weather satellites. These satellites help to study the weather and forecast it. They take the pictures of the movements of the clouds from the space. They have special information cameras. They are having special infrared cameras which take photographs of the heat waves given off by the earth. The temperatures of the different parts of the earth can be calculated from these photographs only. Then next is the Earth observation satellites. These satellites take the photograph of the Earth. They help to locate mineral deposit, fresh water supplies, and new areas where food can be grown. They also help to identify sources of pollution and its effect, as well as to detect the spread of the diseases in the crops, and for the so many uses. Next is the military satellites. These satellites are military satellites or spy satellites, can detect the launch of missiles. It keep watch on the foreign particles or foreigners or enemies. Astronomers use satellite to take spatial measurements of the solar system, stars and galaxies. We know that space travel, astronomers have to undergo intensive training to acquire for the spacewalks, for the space travel. They are having the special suit, that's a space suit. If we see, astronauts have to undergo intensive training to acquire all the skill and knowledge required on a space mission. They learn how to deal with the emergencies in the special laboratories on the ground. They learn how everything will feel in the space. They learn about rocks and soil. They use the latest computer technology. Therefore, they have to be well educated, possessing technical skills. Now, there are many women astronauts too. In space, there is no air, it is very cold and filled with the harmful rays. The space suits that they are wearing, the space suits, here you can see in this image, the space suits that the astronaut wear to protect them from all the harm. The space suit allows the astronaut to work and survive in the space. Okay, the last part of the chapter is landing on the moon. These three great people, great astronauts. We know that moon is the only heavenly body in the space where man has landed. One reason may be that it is closest to the earth. This great man, these three of them, but among three of them, the Neil Armstrong was the first man to step on the surface of the moon on 29 July 1969. This is the Apollo 11 crew. From left, Neil Armstrong, Michael Collins and Edwin Aldrin. Neil Armstrong was the first man to land on the moon. On 20 July 1969, after a voyage of 384,000 kilometer across the space, American spacecraft Apollo 11 landed on the moon. The crew of Apollo 11 were Neil Armstrong, Edwin Aldrin and Michael Collins. American astronaut Neil Armstrong was the first human being to step on the moon. Edwin Aldrin followed after him, later to become the second human being to set foot on the moon. Michael Collins remained abroad and orbited the moon. They left behind various instruments and the American flag. They also brought back 21 kilograms of the rocks and soil from the moon. So students, here we are done with the chapter. I hope you understood. Let's revise a little bit. The surface of the moon has craters, mountains and plain covered with the rock dust. The gravitation force on the moon is 1/6 of that on the earth. There is no atmosphere on the moon. The part of the moon visible to us is called the phases of the moon, tides. Okay, the tides are periodic rise and fall of the large bodies of the water caused by the gravity of the moon and the sun. There are different kinds of the artificial satellites. Astronauts have to undergo intensive training, acquire all the skills and have the knowledge required to the space mission. So I hope you must understood this chapter very easily, because it is very interesting to understand. And if you do not understand, see, watch the video again for 2-3 times. Just share, like and subscribe. Thank you so much, student.